Monkey's helping me do the horse trailer. So I wanted to I kind of was just cleaning it up because it gets kind of dirty and dusty sitting out here. So I went ahead and washed this part to where I could reach it and put a little wax on it. But the roof is just really, really, I have a fiberglass roof. Hi boys, you guys helping me too? So I have a fiberglass roof. And the reason I have a fiberglass roof is it's cooler. So metal roofs get hotter and transfer more heat. Fiberglass stays cooler. Don't have that metal on top. It's also probably a little quieter than the metal popping and shaking. But if you don't condition your fiberglass roof and take care of it, it's not good. So here comes Smokey. What are you doing, boy? He's like, Dad, I'm not going up that ladder with you. So I wanted to show a little bit. So this is the part that I've cleaned and I haven't put conditioner on it yet. There's a fiberglass conditioner. But you see all this green and this hard stuff here? I mean, this shit is freaking like rock, man. This is a really stiff brush in order to get that off. And it's been soaking and it only gets this green stuff on this side. So I'm assuming the wind comes across here. The other side just gets dirty and black. I had a leak there and I put so much damn copper in there, so I'm tired of that leak. Whatever I did, I fixed the leak. But anyway, that was a while ago. You can tell it's all black, that sun hits it. So anyway, I've cleaned that side. Now I'm moving along cleaning this side. And again, I was able to clean that side with just this soft brush, but you notice this soft brush doesn't remove this green stuff. So I had to get the stiffer brush. And I mean, I really have to work it in order to get this off. Then once I get all this off, I have to get that fiberglass conditioner and put a good conditioning on it while it's clean, because it don't stay clean long. All right, so we'll see the finished here. What are you doing, boy? All the critters are coming around. I don't know where that pesky rabbit's at. But Moki decided to come over here. He'll leave when I start squirting and hosing stuff down. So I had a little another spider that built a nest where I was hosing. So I relocated him over here. And I don't know if the big one's gonna eat the little one. So I relocated him or her. But that's her web. So I don't know if she's gonna allow him. Uh-oh, could be problems here. I don't know if they're gonna get along or if they're gonna kill each other, but he was gonna get killed over there where I was at. So I was like, let me put him on a web. If he's a male, you know, maybe we can get a little bow, 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 action, spider action here. I gotta go finish cleaning my, so I don't even know if those are the same freaking species of, I think they are. So he's on one side of the nest and she's on the other side. If it's a he, I was told the males are smaller. Oh man, that sun's hot out here, God. So they both got six legs. I think most spiders got six legs. I gotta go finish. Oh, there goes the boys looking for their little escape route. They're like, hey, maybe the fence is down again. Little shits. Checking that fence line. So, this is right in the middle of me doing my horse trailer video. I'm cleaning the top of the fiberglass roof. So this is a little guy here. And that's mama. So neither one of them's moving. So I'm kind of wondering if they're get-along spiders or if they're fighting spiders. I gotta keep that clear background so I can kind of see in case the action goes down.
So I'll stop it. If the action starts, I'll turn. Oh, wait a minute. I spoke too soon. I wouldn't think Mama would wrap up another spider, would she? I guess we're about to find out. Because they're pretty close. But I figured the other one could like run off the web if he didn't want to be there. I just figured I'd bring him over here because he was going to get taken out. Oh, uh-oh. Oh shit, she is taking him out. Wow. She beat his ass. Dude, I'm sorry, man. I brought you over here to kind of save you. Wow. That wasn't much of a save, was it? Wow. Well, I guess Mama wants a meal. Is she wrapping him or stabbing him? I can't tell on this little screen. Maybe it'll come out better on the video. Darn, he wasn't fast enough to get away. I couldn't tell if I got it on camera or not when they both scurried away. But it's definitely, she got him wrapped up. All you girls who are afraid of spiders, I've seen spiders do this to people when they're sleeping. So I wouldn't even sleep in my house if I were you, because I've seen spiders wrap up a person like this, like when they fall asleep. Okay, so it shot back to the middle of the nest. I guess it wrapped up Billy Bob there pretty good. Sorry, dude. I was trying to save you. You were gonna die anyway over there. So Mama got him. All right, on that one there, I gotta go back and finish my top of that trailer. Still cleaning up there. Mokey's around here somewhere. Okay, so I finished cleaning it off and I'll let it dry overnight, and then tomorrow I'll put some conditioner on it, fiberglass conditioner. Hi, horse people. All right, so I'm still working on this trailer here. And of course, every time I start a project, it creates 10 other projects. So I finally got the roof clean, and then I put some wax on this, the spray-on ceramic stuff. I'll let you know how it holds up. You just spray it on, rub it on. And then as I'm working on this, I noticed that this little hook right here is totally rusted out down here. And it like rusted in to where I couldn't even drill out the holes. I had to get vice grips and literally scrape off the rust and then squeeze them with vice grip and twist the vice grip to get the screws out. So I don't know. They only sell these in like 10 packs for 15, these little twist-ons. And I was like, I don't need 15 just for one. And this one just stops the flapping. So I'm not sure what I'm doing. I'm going to try to find a place that just has one. And then the reason why it's painted is that these were all rusty. And I was like, I was going to get a new one of these. But they're like 50 bucks or 60. I was like, shit, this is working fine. I don't use it. So I just sprayed some white paint on it front and back to stop the rusting, that Rust-Oleum. And then that I put the black rust converter because it was really rusted. And then I'm going to spray paint over that white. So I just covered the little rusted parts with white. That one wasn't bad, so I left it alone. This one was okay, but the back part was rusted, so I sprayed that. So, you know, of course I had to, and then this was all rusty and water was staying down in here. And I put those holes in there a while ago, but if you drill little holes in for a drain, you have to make sure that they stay clean. So if you don't clean this, then dust and stuff get in there and the drug holes. So I cleaned that out. What the hell else did I do, man? This trailer just came into a freaking major, you know, and of course, when I'm going through this to kind of get rid of weight, I find things that I haven't used, like this is a rasp. You screw this on the rasp so you have a handle. And then I had a couple knives in there, which amazingly have been in here for freaking 10 years and not rusted. I mean, I was like, wow. So I'm going to clean them up, put a coat of oil on them. I found a couple things like this rope and
some, I always like having different ropes and things because you never know if you go out either camping or you get stuck to where you may have to tie either a tent, a side, whatever. You can just, so I have a lot of things in here that I can kind of use. Found this orange string, so now I gotta go cut me a piece of wood so I can wrap it because I'm tired of it getting knotted up and taking 20 minutes when I need it. So I'm gonna go cut a little piece of wood with a couple V's in it and then wrap it around that. So that's another project. So again, I sprayed it down with ceramic stuff. I'll show you what I used to spray it down. It looks okay. You know, it's pretty easy. I've got a lot of spray on stuff that I use. Of course, I got my, Pat calls them my brother basketball shoes on because I run around here at socks. So I had to slip these on to come out. And when I used to play basketball at the gym, you wear these into the gym so you don't get rocks and dirt on your good court shoes because you don't want your court shoes slipping or getting rocks or dirty. And so you bring your shoes in and then you change once you get in. So instead of changing from one pair of tuning shoes like others, most guys just go in and flip-flops and they take these off and throw their basketball shoes on. But that's another episode. There's the boys out there. All right, so I tried moving this damn ladder around and doing it from a ladder and that just didn't work. So then I tried getting on here and kneeling down here. My knees were like killing me and I was shit. So I got these two little foam things, which I really love. You can get like a four packet at Harbor Freight. Usually they go on sale. That's when I got these, when they were on sale. And then I just use it for kneeling. Moki likes to play on them and lay on them. It's insulation, so he can lay on it on the concrete. I keep them laying around. Anytime I need to kneel down, I grab them. So I grabbed a couple of these and I just basically kneeled down and went up and down. And then after I cleaned it, I put some conditioner. You can tell where it's cracking here. And because this is a fiberglass roof, I mean, I don't know how bad this is going to be. It's undercover. So this is the part that's getting most of the sunlight. I found a couple chips in there that I think I'm going to put some silicone on unless somebody gives me a better tip in here. And I need to replace that thing because that thing's been nothing but a leak. I caulked the hell out of it. I stopped the leak. Now I just noticed the lid's cracked. So I think that's going to be another replacement project. And then I notice on the screws that the little washers are all dried out. So I have two options. I can put a little caulk around a screw and not mess with it, or I can unscrew it and put a new washer on it. I would rather unscrew it and put a new washer, but if I unscrew it, I may make problems on the internal, not get it back in, it may be rusted. So I may end up creating a problem. So I think my best option is if it ain't broke, don't fix it. I'm just gonna put a little bead of silicone around each of those screws. And then ain't no telling what project I'll find in the middle of that one. But like everything, look at those boys. What's dad mess with the trailer? He's gonna take us to that damn vet. Don't get in that trailer, buddy's telling him. Stay away from that damn trailer. Oh shit. And of course, you notice I have three ladders out, right? Because I was like, well, maybe I can just kind of reach it with this. That didn't work. So I said, well, maybe I'll get higher with that. Well, that didn't work. And the only way I can get up there was, I can get up there on this ladder, but I can't get down without breaking my neck. So I had to get the big ladder out in order to climb up there so I could climb down. And so the trailer's cleaned up, washed up, sprayed that wax on it where it was rusting a little bit. You can tell I sprayed it with some white, that Rust-Oleum paint. My hinges were rusted. I kind of cleaned them up with a little Rust-Oleum paint. This was really, really rusted bad. So I cleaned this up with a little Rust-Oleum paint. I really should have took this off. This is supposed to stop this from coming undone, which it never has, probably never will, but it just gives me a little safety Sally security. So on the top of the thing, I was looking for the best thing to take care of fiberglass. And this was one of the things, and I had this already because I put this on my hose and some other rubber things because it gives good UV protection. And so I sprayed it down with that. I was gonna go order something. I go, shit, I got that. I'll just use that. And it seemed like it worked okay. Of course, I don't know how it's gonna hold up with the rain and stuff. So I guess I'll go cut that. I think I have any other crazy projects up here. Of course, the ladder was a freaking mess. It was dirty because it was hanging up. So I had to clean the ladder before I could even use it because it had crap everywhere. Then I found one of Smokey's heads that he didn't eat the mice, so I sprinkled some of that DE on it because the ants were coming from that little ant bed right there and eating it. They're still eating it.
So I had to do that. And then in the middle, the boys wanted something snack. So I had to put some fly spray on them and then give them a snack. The hell else did I do? You can't do one thing without it, you know, going crazy. Feed the rabbit, cleaned up some things. I found these rubber gloves in there. This is what happens so these are the two knives that were in there, and I was freaking astonished. This thing's made in China, and it hasn't rusted. I mean, it rusted a little bit, kind of right there on the top, you can see, but not much. I mean, I was kind of shocked. I expected that to be a rusty mess. This one I haven't opened yet, but it doesn't look too bad either. So I'm gonna oil those two things down. I found this buckle in there. I'm not sure why it was in there. It was extra weight. Sometimes I keep these when I lose something in case I need to fix a belt or something. So now I have an extra belt buckle. So I might just go ahead and clean it up while I have that. This flashlight has been there for freaking, I don't know how many years, and it freaking worked. Oh shit. It worked when I turned it on. There it is. I couldn't believe it. So I'm gonna change the batteries and clean the interior of that. This is an old rasp cover to protect your rasp. You slide your rasp in there and then it doesn't get rusted. And I forgot I had that. That was sticking in that thing that I was cleaning up. But this was interesting because I pulled this out and I go, what the hell is this? And I was like, why the hell do I have all this shit? And it feels all crusty. This is what happens to rubber gloves when you don't use them. So normally I put them in these bags to make them last longer. But this is literally just melted from heat. They degrade. And all these rubber gloves. Now remember, these rubber gloves, this is what I carried in my pocket when I was working as a cop in Sacramento. This is what Sacramento issued, was these blue ones. So we'd know they were from us. A lot of agents wore black. In fact, I don't know if they still use blue or not. But so these things are a little old, but I can't use any of them because they're trashed. So now I keep my gloves in these things so I can just unscrew them when I need it. But it keeps the air from it and they don't deteriorate as quick. So I have some black gloves and some blue gloves. So I'm going to replace, get me a new plastic bag. I'm not going to use this bag because this, although the Ziploc bag held up good, it didn't degrade at all. But the gloves inside, man, they're trashed. I mean, it's a freaking mess. Look at that shit. Woo, doggies. So I'm gonna get me a new plastic bag there and put me some new gloves because you always wanna have rubber gloves in your horse trailer. Either for doctoring, if you get hurt, if someone else gets hurt, if you gotta do a greasy job, having rubber gloves in the trailer is a good deal. So I gotta replace that. Again, this all started with I was just gonna clean the roof and condition it. And now, you know, 8 hours later, I'm into 14 different projects. So I forgot I was going to show you what I used on that. So this is what I sprayed it down with, this hybrid ceramic. It got a really good thing. It's turtle wax. I usually use this turtle wax, and I love it. This stuff works freaking great. And you put it on, and then you don't even really need to buff it off. This is a ceramic coating, so you don't buff it off at all. I mean, you can buff it off, but I just put it on. What you see there is I just wiped it on with a rag. Then I heard this ice was supposed to be, this one's almost empty, so I'm going to use it. But they're all turtle wax, and they all freaking work good. So I'm happy with all this. Here's some rubbing compound. This stuff I haven't tried yet. It's called a bead maker. It was supposedly number one. So I don't know how good it is or not, but it's supposed to, like, give great beading protection. And then this Meguiar's Ultra Wax, this is good because it doesn't leave white. So I use this on my motorcycle because it's black. And if you don't miss a little wax spot on a motorcycle, it really shows up. Well, this doesn't dry white. So this is pretty good wax. I have another Total Wax back there. I think one of the stores was closing down. They had a special on these. They were like giving them all a half price. So I was like, shit, I'll take one of those and one of those. So. So that's the stuff I use. What the hell else did I find? I thought I found something else in there. Shit, who knows? All right, so this is the horse trailer video, and unless I come up with more projects, this will be the last one. We'll end that one there.
Figured I would add in. This took me about 5 or 10 minutes, no big deal. Grab a little steel wool, grab a little 3-in-1 oil, put it on there, gave them a little scrub down, removed any of the little rust. And they look fine. They look good to go for
another 10 years. And these was like what I call my throwdown knives anyway. They're not real good knives. They're just kind of old junkers. I was like, I'll throw it in a horse trailer because I need it. These must be pretty good batteries because they didn't freaking leak and they still got power. And this thing has been in there for years. So made sure there's no rust in here. And I'm going to put three new batteries in this thing, which will probably freaking leak in 6 months now because I changed it instead of leaving it. But it's not very bright. And it's not consistent. All right, I forgot to update that. Everybody's always saying, you say you're going to fix something and you never show. All right, I'm showing it. Look, so I got the little piece of wood that I had left over. It was this tongue and groove. I did my closets and that, I think I did a thing on it for that smelly good stuff, whatever that wood is that smells good. So I had a couple extra pieces. I cut two V's on each end real quick. And then I drilled a little hole there and I had some leftover pink string that they left when they were doing concrete or whatever. And now I'll just hang that in the trailer. And my string won't be always balled up. I replaced these batteries. Now it's really bright. Nice light. Put that back in there. This, in case you didn't understand what that was, to go on a rasp. So when you have a rasp like this, they sell these little things and they got little grooves on the inside. It was rusted. I put some rust converter. So I sprayed it down there because it was a little rusted. And so then all you do is stick it on here and you literally just screw it. And it bites into this metal, and then it gives you a handle when you're doing your rasp. And this, in case you didn't understand that, you slide your rasp in there to protect it. And I didn't slide it in there. Let's see if I can get that off. Okay. So now I have a handle for a rasp. This is my old rasp that I kept out. And you can keep old rasps for a lot of things. They're still rough. Do a little grinding. If my horse has dried mud on them, this takes it off really good. Doesn't rip the hair out, but it rips the mud off. And the horses seem to like it. You got the smooth side. If I need to just file something down real quick, I can grab this because it's old. A lot of people just throw them away. I keep them laying around because I can use them for something. I mean, if anything, I can hit somebody in the head with it. Give Buddy a spanking. So that's that. And then, I didn't get my glove. I threw away my glove thing, but I didn't get a new plastic bag for the gloves. So I still need to do that. And then I finished painting out here. You saw the, I sprayed that black rust converter on here, and this was all black, remember? And so now I just covered it in a coat of that Rust-Oleum paint. And now I'll just decide on whether to buy one of those, if I can find one of those, one of these little things, or come up with some other thing that I can screw in there to hold that. Again, it's not really weight-bearing. These are more your two weight-bearing ones. So those are going to hold the weight. But anyway, those are my projects. And the gloves, I paired them up, rolled them into one set. So I have five different sets of gloves in here. And, that way, if I need a set, I can just grab it. Then I roll up the bag. I seal the bag until the last corner, rolled all the air out. Then I sealed the last corner. So it gives that kind of vacuum. Hopefully that'll keep these gloves from degrading for another 10 years. All right. Trailer cleaning the roof project is done. That was the last thing. Ladders are up. Things are put away. I'm done.